गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, वी आर डूइंग द अकाउंटिंग टर्मिनोलॉजीज. सो अप टू 20 वी हैव डन. नाउ आई एम स्टार्टिंग विद 21. नेक्स्ट इज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल्स. ट्रेड रिसीवेबल मीन्स इट इज़ द अमाउंट रिसीवेबल फॉर सेल ऑफ गुड्स एंड और सर्विसेज रेंडर इन द ऑर्डनरी कोर्स ऑफ बिजनेस. मीन्स वी कैन सेल द गुड्स एंड वी कैन प्रोवाइड द सर्विसेज ऑल्सो, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वन अमाउंट इज रिसीवेबल. रिसीवेबल मीन्स इन फ्यूचर डेट वी आर हैविंग द राइट टू रिसीव दैट अमाउंट. दैन इट इज रिसीवेबल. दैट मीन्स यू हैव नॉट रिसीव्ड बट इट इज रिसीवेबल. दैट मीन्स ट्रेड रिसीवेबल्स आर जनरेटेड बिकॉज ऑफ द क्रेडिट सेल्स ऑफ गुड्स और सर्विसेज. बिकॉज सेटलमेंट इज नॉट डन इमीडिएट. बिकॉज इफ दे हैव पेड द कैश पेमेंट इन दैट सिचुएशन दे आर नॉट रिसीवेबल्स बिकॉज नाउ द सेटलमेंट इज डन. Okay, these are generated because of the credit sales of goods or services. Basically, it is amount due from the customers of the enterprise. When you are doing the credit sales, then they are the customers. Now, the next is, one more thing is there. Basically, trade receivables includes two things. One is debtor and second is BR. The difference between the debtor and BR is that in case of BR, the customer is not known to us, or maybe we are not that much sure that he will make the payment. The reason is that maybe his financial position is not strong, or that person is unknown, okay, or because of his past behavior. What will we do? We will create a bill with that person, and that bill is a negotiable instrument which is signed by the customer that he will make the payment on this specified date. So basically, this document is accepted by the debtor and signed by the debtor duly. So that debtor is known as BR. But with our customer, if we are not creating this bill, then that customer is known as debtors. Understood the difference now? That both the cases, to debtors and BR, we are selling the goods on credit and they will make the payment in future. Only in case of BR, we are preparing the bill which is signed by the debtor. But in a case of debtors, no such bills is prepared. Okay. Now, debtors and BR, both, in both the cases, they are trade receivables, and organization is having the right that that organization will recover the money from its receivables, that is debtors and BR. So that's why they are the assets of the organization and these are the current assets, because the organization will recover the money within a short period of time, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. Only this much credit period is allowed to the customers. Okay, so they are the current assets. Now next is trade payables. It is the opposite of trade receivables. In case of trade payables, we are saying that when one person is selling the goods on credit, so the second person is purchasing on credit, as simple as that. For example, you are buying something from the shop and you are not making the immediate payment. So it is credit purchase for you because you are purchasing, but for the shopkeeper it is credit sales. So now we have done the credit sales. Now we will look from the point of credit purchases. Now, trade payables means the amount payable by the organization in the ordinary course of business. In the ordinary course of business means the business operations which it is doing, that is the production of the goods. For that production of the goods, if the organization is buying any sort of goods or services on credit, then that is taken as trade payables. So basically, it is the amount due to the seller. Due means we have to pay this amount in the near future. Now, trade payables includes two things. One is creditors and second is bills payable. Like we have done there in receivable, debtors and bills receivable. Now, the difference again is same. In case of bills payable, a bill is prepared. It is known as bill of exchange. In case of BR, that is also a bill of exchange which is prepared. And it is signed by us now. Why? Because always the purchaser is going to sign that bill, that he will make the payment on this particular date. Understood now? So it will be signed by the person, accepted by the person, that he will make the payment on this specified date. Now if I am doing the credit purchases, then I will sign it. Okay, but if I am doing the credit sales, then my customer will sign. Understood? Because the person who is going to make the payment in future, that person will sign it. Okay, but in case of creditors, we are selling the goods on credit, but we are not preparing or we are not creating these kinds of bills. That is the only difference. Now, when we are preparing the bill, the same case is there when the customer is, the supplier is known to us, or maybe he is known to our financial position. As per his thinking that our financial position is strong, we will make the payment timely. Then they are not preparing the bills. Okay. Now, the next is cost. Wait now. Okay. Now we are doing the cost. Cost is the simple word as we are using in the mass question we are doing. Now we are calculating profit, loss, cost. So it is basically that cost. It is the amount of expenditure incurred or attributable to a specified article, product or activity. Now cost we can calculate of a goods also. We can calculate of a service also. Cost means when I am producing a product. So how much amount I am spending to produce that product is known as the cost of the product. Okay, expenditure associated with the production of that good or activity or service. Now next is voucher. Voucher is a very important, you know, evidence in case of accounting, because we are saying that everything is recorded in the books of accounts by the accountant. He is passing the entries, he is doing the entries in the books of account. So now accountant can do the fraud easily. Instead of writing 1 lakh, he can write down 10 lakh, so 9 lakh will be in pocket. Okay, because in the books of accounts they are saying that he has company has purchased the goods of 10 lakh, but in the books of accounts they are showing that company has purchased the goods of 20 lakh. So 10 lakh will be in the pocket of accountant. So to eliminate this sort of frauds, vouchers are prepared in a business organizations. How many business transactions are there, that much vouchers are created. Voucher will support that transaction. Voucher will give a evidence that actually this transaction has been taken place. For example, if we are buying something, then bills will be prepared. If cash is received by the organization or cash is paid, then cash memos will be prepared. Okay, if we are buying or selling the goods on credit, then we are preparing the debit note and credit notes. Now the next is that are known as vouchers. Means vouchers means basically the bills we are preparing, the cash memos we are preparing, invoice we are preparing, so that they can be used and as an evidence of a business transaction. And remember one thing, only those transactions are passed in the books of accounts which are supported by the vouchers. Now next is discount. Discount means the same meaning as we are as you are listening in the markets, that every product has some selling price, and whenever the seller is giving some sort of rebate or reduction in that price, that is known as discount. Now discount is of two types. One is straight discount and second is cash discount. That is something new for you. Okay, now when we are doing the shopping in the malls, outside it is written that 60% off, 20% off, 30% off. Okay, that is the trade discount. When discount given to everyone so that the sales can be increased, Now in that case, that is trade discount. And whenever any organization, any supplier is giving trade discount to us, it is not recorded in the books of account. For example, I am purchasing a product of 1000, already 30 is off, so I will record directly 700. I will not show anything. I will show the purchase price as 700. Cash discount is slightly different. Trade discount, I am saying, it is not recorded anywhere, only the net value is recorded in the books of accounts. Okay, now cash discount means, for example, outside it is written that 30% is off. Okay, the product is of 1000, so 1000 minus 30 is 700. Now after that 700, if the seller is saying that if you make the immediate payment, I will give you 100 rupees extra discount, that is the cash discount. Cash discount is given by the organization so that the immediate cash payments can be increased. Okay, whenever you are buying a product in cash, that is somehow cheaper as compared to whenever you are buying on the credit. Generally it happens in the market, you know that. Basically in case of organizations, because there is regular dealing is done, so that is the cash discount. Now cash discount is not given to everyone. Cash discount will be given only to those persons who are making the payment immediately. who are making the cash payment, who are purchasing on cash basis. So it is recorded in the books of account of both the parties. Okay. Now, if I am recording this transaction, so it will be written as 700 minus 100. 700 will be recorded and 100 will also be recorded as discount. But in case of trade discount, we are not recording it. We are just recording the net value. Now, next is bad debts. Bad debts is the amount owed to the business that is written off because it has become irrecoverable. It is a loss for the business and it's thus debited to the profit and loss account. Now, debtors we have done, BR we have done. Debtors and BR, bills receivable, are those persons or entities which has promised that they will make the payment on a future date because we have done the credit sales to them. Now, maximum time these payments are recovered, but sometimes it happens that the debtors or the BR, they are saying that we are not having the money, or they become they are not having the money, their financial position is not strong, or sometimes many more reasons are there, they are not paying our amount. So they are known as bad debts of the organization. So basically bad debts are those generally those debtors which has refused to pay the money. That's why those debtors which are irrecoverable, those BRs which are irrecoverable, matlab jinse paise ab recover nahi honge, that is written off, matlab unhe khatam kar diya jata hai, books of accounts mein show nahi kiya jata, unhe debtors ki category mein se hata diya jata hai, then it is known as bad debts. Now next is balance sheet. Like we are preparing one statement of profit and loss account to calculate how much profit we have earned, balance sheet is also a statement which is prepared to know the financial position. Balance sheet basically is divided into two parts, left hand side and right hand side. On left hand side we are writing all the liabilities and capital of the business, and on the debit side we are writing all the assets, so that we can compare the financial position and we can get an idea about our financial strength. Now next is book value. Book value means the amount at which the entries will be recorded in the financial statement, that is the book value. For example, I am having a machinery that I have purchased on 1 lakh, so I am recording it on 1 lakh. So 1 lakh is the book value, means the value at which that asset is recorded, so that is the book value. Now next is the books of accounts. Books of accounts means when we are preparing the accounts of an organization, there is a huge list of account which we are preparing. So when we are taking all these accounts in a compiled form together, all the records which we are preparing for each and every financial transactions, that records or that set of account is known as books of accounts. Now next is cost of goods sold. It is basically cost attributable to the production of goods sold or service. Now the word production is, it is written there. I am giving you one example because cost we have done earlier also. Cost of goods sold are slightly different. For example, I am producing a cost, so that is the cost of production of goods. But after producing the goods, I am incurring so much expenses so that this goods can be sold. I am doing advertising, I am doing marketing. Okay, we are giving the discount, so much things we are using that. So that is the cost of sales. But when I am saying cost of goods sold, then I will take the expenditures only up to the production. That up to, if I am producing the goods, what will be the cost of producing only, up to the point of producing. Now next is credit. Now when we are making the account, it is divided into two parts. One is left hand side and right hand side. Okay, just we will put one between line between the account. Left hand side is known as debit side and right hand side is known as credit side. When we are making the accounts, then these terms I will explain in detail. Okay, now the next is depreciation. Depreciation means it is the fall in the value of an asset. Whenever we are purchasing any asset, for example, today I have purchased a machinery of rupees 20 lakh, okay, and its value is 5 years. So for 5 years and I have purchased the machinery and it is going to, I am going to have this machinery for 5 years. So for 5 years it will be shown in the books of accounts, but its value will be shown 20 lakh, 20 lakh, 20 lakh. Now think about the situation after 5 years. The machinery
is recorded in the books of account at its book value. Book value means at price at which it is recorded, that is 20 lakh. Now tell me, after 5 years, books of accounts are showing that the value of machinery is 20 lakh. It is true. It is correct. No, because now the value has reduced because 5 year has gone and its value has reduced. So that's why we are saying that when we are using machinery or any asset we are using, because of the passage of time, because of the accidents, because of the usage or because of the obsolescence, sometimes new technologies are coming and the technology which we are having associated with the machinery that become obsolete, wo purani ho jati hai. That's why the value of the asset is decreasing. Okay, so this decrease in the value, this fall in the value is known as depreciation, and in books of accounts we are recording this fall of asset with each and every accounting period. We will reduce the value of the asset by write like that machinery 20 lakh minus 10,000 as depreciation every year, so that its value can be reduced. Now entity, next term. An entity means an economic unit which performs economic activities. Okay, entity is the unit which is performing the activities to earn the profit because it is an economic entity. A business entity means an enterprise established in accordance with the law to encourage in business activities. This includes proprietorship firms. Proprietorship firm means when business is run by a single owner. Partnership firm, when business is done by the partners. Corporations and companies, these are the big houses. These all are known as entity. Now, the next is. Now the next is entry. We have done the business transactions, that in the business transactions are taking place. Now that transactions or even when they are recorded in the books of accounts, they are known as entry. Okay, the transactions which we are recording in the books of accounts, that is known as entry, that we are passing the entry for this business transaction. Next is insolvent. Insolvent means Hindi mein hum ise kehte hain diwaliya. Insolvent means when a person is unable to pay its liability, okay, to pay its debt, okay, that known as insolvent. And it is not necessary that always a person is insolvent. Organizations, companies, they are also becoming insolvent. Vijay Mallya, have you listened about that case? He has taken the loan from the banks, but after a few years he is saying that my company is not having the funds to return it, okay, I am not having that much financial funds. So in that case, that company is known as insolvent. Why insolvent? Because it is unable to pay its debt. That means udhariyan, apni udhar ko pay karne ke liye company ya person unable ho jata hai, us position ko insolvent kehte hain. Now proprietor means that person who is taking the decision to invest his or her money and ready to bear the risk associated with that investment, that is known as proprietor. Aam bhasha mein hum isko owner bhi keh dete hain, because that person is taking the decision to invest his capital or her capital and he is observing all the risk associated with that investment. Jo paisa usne invest kiya, ab usse jo bhi profit hoga ya loss hoga, usko kaun bear karega? Proprietor. So ab jabhi bhi ye word aata hai, profit hoga ya loss hoga, that means there is a matter of chance, and because of that matter of chance, uncertainty is there, so risk is there. So this risk is bear by the proprietor. Now next is rebate. When we are when a reduction in price is done so that the sales can be increased, that is known as discount. But there are so many things are there that we are reducing the price of the product not to increase the sale, but so many things are there, and if with that another reason we are reducing the price, then it is known as rebate. I am giving you one example. Rate discount, cash discount, we have done. But sometimes we are not want to increase the sale. Sometimes we are just reducing the price. Sometimes I know that my product is not of a better quality and it is not going to be sale. So what I will do? I will reduce the price. Now the objective is not to increase the sale. The objective is to just sold that product because it is a poor quality or defective piece. Sometimes what we are thinking that okay, the financial position is not that much good of that customer, or he has the necessity of this product, so we are reducing the price. So these all things, these all reductions in the price without without that reason, without with that purpose for which we are allowing the trade discount or cash discount, then it is known as rebate. Now next term is solvent, which is opposite to the term of insolvent. Solvent is a person which is able to pay his debts. Okay, when a person is that much financial strong that he can pay his debts easily, then he is known as solvent. Financial statement. Financial statement means the statements which are prepared by an organization so that it can ascertain its profit or loss and its financial position. जो statements एक organization इसलिए बनाती है ताकि उसे पता चल सके during an accounting period उसने कितना profit और loss earn किया है और उसकी financial position क्या है. Financial position means उसके पास कितने assets हैं, कितनी उसकी liabilities हैं. Then that set of statement is known as financial statement. Financial statement includes two things. One, profit and trading account, profit and loss account. They are taken as combined one, okay? They are known as income statements. Because through these statements, we are ascertaining our income, profit and loss we are saying. And second is our financial position statement, which is known as balance sheet. This financial statement we will do at the end of the, you know, the last 2-3 chapters of the book are related to financial statements, where we will do the practical that how we are preparing the profit and loss account, how we are preparing the balance sheet. So these are all the accounting terms which you are going to understand. You can see only short type questions will become from this chapter. What is rebate? What is trade receivables? What is cash discount? Only that two lines will become, and you have to explain that meaning only. Okay, no long questions are generally formed in this chapter. All questions generally form in the form of short type of question. So now syllabus is completed, revise it. And I'm sending question answers in the form of MCQs. Do that. If you are having any problem, I'm not providing you answers so that I come to know that you are doing or not. Because when you are doing, you are facing the problem, you will ask to me. Okay. So I will provide questions together with this video. Complete that. Now, thank you class and all the best for your duty one.